Okay. So the presentation that I'm doing is about for our ongoing project, which is you are developing a new spot welding method, and it's ongoing. So it's somehow the proof of concept. So this study comes from the project that we have for dissimilar joining. We already work on dissimilar composite material, aluminium composite and aluminium polymers. However, as it's proven, the tool has the main effect in the friction-assisted welding or any welding process. We tried different tools to see the different results, and we improve the tool stage by stage as we go along. In the beginning, we use the normal tool, conventional friction-assisted welding tool with the rotating shoulder prow, as you see. We tried the polymer with aluminium, also the long fiber composite, which is not a good option for welding. As you know, the long fiber would damage and which will be critically failure from that part. So we decided to go back one step, that use the tool that we use for in my thesis, PhD thesis, which was the friction-assisted welding tool with the heat shoe, which is basically there is a copper sleeve around the probe as long as the stationary shoulder. So the frictional heat is between the rotating probe and the copper. This tool was able to produce for polymeric material up to 97%. So 97% of the tensile strength compared to the base material. So we try to use the same tool for the composite and see how it will behave. And as we can see on the left side, we tried with the polypropylene, 5 millimeter, and polyethylene, sorry, and the composite on the right side. So however, we couldn't generate enough friction on the surface to melt the aluminium, but we could deform it, as you can see, it's the interlocking area. However, couldn't call it a welding, so we took a different approach, which was spot welding. So in this method, we try to introduce two different methods in single process, which is friction stirrer spot welding and riveting technique. So this was the first trial that we did until the final tool design for our concept. So we had some the fixture, and we had the two molds on the both sides for the bottom and top to create the mold, and also a consumer probe, which as you can see, the gray part. So the probe would rotate inside the base material, create the friction and steer the material together. And then under the optimal axial force, the riveting creates on the both sides. So in a single process, we could have the steering effect of deformation of the base material as long as the riveting, which usually is two different operations. And also, for example, for friction stirrer spot welding, one issue is the keyhole defect. In this case, we don't. Or for riveting is the hole that you have to make and the material doesn't mix together. To prove that, we used short fiber printed material from Carfab with the copolyester resin. It had a 20% short fiber, so we printed the special, and also we put a pre-defined hole there as it would guide the material better, but at the end, it wouldn't have the hole for our welding operation. And to be sure, I produced several specimens with this very simple tool, and to see how it behaves, we did some X-ray. But first, I will show you. So this is the bottom die of the tool. So the bottom riveting effects, the material sits there, the top fixture, and then the tool penetrates into the base material. So this is the end result, as you see. So we have the consumable tool that retracts from the part. We cut one in the half. To see how properly the material mix together and how strong it is. And after doing the X-ray, it was very interesting for us to see how different areas in the steering area compared to the base material, which in this case is the printing. As you see, in the printing area, you can see all the layers and all the gaps between, but in the middle, the steering effect is totally different. It enhances the joint on the center. However, as you can see, there are very huge bubbles in the between, as it was not automatic process and nothing optimized, which this situation will be solved by optimizing the parameter. However, as you can see, we have the riveting on the both sides. Also, we have a very good mixture in between. Also, we study the rotation of the fibers. As you can see, this is on the right side, or the fiber are all circular in the spot welding area. And for it's a bit different in the base material. However, it's not, it wasn't that easy to exactly say the fiber direction and how it behaves, as the fiber were very small, as you can see here. So this was to see how the short fibers behave after the process. And as you can see from the each color, that's the fiber direction. You cannot see much difference between the steering area and the base material in this case, but it is ongoing, and we are developing a new tool to improve the current process and also to mechanically characterize. So basically, this method we are going to develop it and hopefully patent it. So it has the benefits of the both of the methods, which is, for example, to a steering to have this comparative riveting effect on the both sides, and none of the disadvantage, for example, no keyhole, or for riveting you need to make a hole, and that is the stress riser. So we are very hopeful for this method, and we are trying to develop it further, and maybe ultimately to a portable tool, and it's not just used for the welding, but it can be used for repairing as well. Thank you. If there is any questions.